I didn't know how to be safe, because no one teaches you how to be safe. Like, even in your own body, you just assume feeling like this is okay, or like doing that is okay, when in reality it's probably not okay for you.
Kia ora, I'm Zakara, I'm 19 years old. I know what it's like to be in a position where you feel you're alone or you don't have anybody to hang out with. Because I even remember in high school, if you weren't popular enough, you know, you're not good enough, when it should be your inside.
Getting into a comfortable position. Closing down the eyes. If you don't feel comfortable closing down the eyes, you can just gaze down to the floor. And I'm gonna take you guys through this safety meditation. So we're gonna inhale and exhale. Putting your hands on your belly if you feel comfortable with that, or on your heart, or giving yourself a nafi. Inhaling and exhaling. Inhaling and exhaling. While we're sitting here breathing, I want you guys to think of a thought, good or bad. Something stressful, could be whatever you're thinking of that's been on your head and you just don't want it anymore. Inhaling and exhaling. Inhaling and exhaling. Now that we have this thought, we're gonna put it on the cloud. That's the only cloud on the sky. And each time we breathe, it's gonna float away or drift away. Inhaling or exhaling. Inhaling and exhaling. Inhaling and exhaling. Now that the clouds drifted away, we're gonna set a new intention. This intention could be something you wanna focus on, or it could start with, I will, or I will be calm. Just something you wanna put your energy towards this today, or within this week, or months. We're just gonna breathe or thinking of an intention. Inhaling or thinking, no rush, and exhaling. Inhaling and exhaling. Now that we have our new intention, we're gonna inhale and hold it. And exhale to lock it. Slowly coming back to the space and opening your eyes when you're ready in your own time.
People make school seem like it's this amazing, luxurious thing, but there's all these like cons to it. Like I remember getting bullied in primary school, a bit of intermediate, but then it stopped. And then high school, it was for my weight. It may just be like words, but they stick like glue. And then like, because of how young I was, it stuck with me until I grew up. I wanted to be that perfect student, especially for my family, like be perfect and like be like the school excellence person and like look good. after leaving primary school, you learn that there's no perfect student. You grow up and you learn, wow, school, there's all these challenges that no one, like, gives you advice on or teaches you. People that are grown up in a rough patch think there's nothing for them. But there's, like, all these options.
If someone asked, how do you feel safe physically and mentally, what would be your advice to give them?
For me, it's not really a place where I feel unsafe. It's more like a situation. When I'm in an unsafe situation, I'm not me, and I don't feel like me. And I think to make myself feel safe is my thoughts. If that makes sense. Just being by myself, taking time to heal, I guess.
A lot of the time I don't even know it's happening until there's like a bit of quiet or stillness. I start noticing that my stomach feels weird. There's like butterflies or I'm like really tense. I'm like, why am I like this? And then different things start to trigger me. I'm like, oh, right. And then I just start breaking it down. I'm like, oh, this happened. I felt this way. This is how I reacted. Okay, now I know to watch out for that next time. And it's just finding those resources or things that make you feel safe. And they don't have to be like the biggest things. Like for me, it's just being warm. Whenever I feel unsafe, chuck on a jacket or like find the nearest fireplace with a blanket and just doing that for yourself.
It's not every day you get an opportunity for someone to teach you meditation or yoga. You know, when I first started it, I looked at it as in like it was for skinny, fit people and not like plus size people. Because I know for me, it helped me open up to myself. Being in school, I was like such a shy person and I didn't like big groups, big crowds, and making new friends. That was something I didn't like doing. And you grow up thinking that nobody will ever understand you. And especially with like young ones, they grow up getting taught all this stuff. They don't get taught how to like maintain their feelings and emotions when like that's the most important thing you should learn. Like small things, helping people and stuff teaches me to get more out there. That maybe if I help somebody, even though I'm a shy person and I like to be an introvert, that if I help somebody, they'll learn to help someone else and then it'll just keep going. It'll just be a cycle. Don't beat yourself up for things you can't control. Just let it flow. And if it happens, then it happens. Just get right back up.